Hi everyone, my name is Yawung Zidir and welcome back to my channel, The Atra Kid. If you are new here, please do consider to subscribe. If you are not new here, welcome back to my channel once again. As you can see in the title of the video, I'm making a chatty video where you guys will get to know me. So I'll tell you the reason behind shooting this video. So whenever I post a video, I get comments from people asking me things like what's your full name and you know things like where do you live in Delhi, what do you do in Delhi and which camera do you use, which editing software do you use and a lot of questions like that. So I sometimes reply to them, but then I get tired to reply as well, since in one video I get at least like 3 to 4 people asking the same questions like which camera do you use and stuff. So I thought why not just shoot a video directly and answer them all. So I have put up a set of questions by myself according to, because I know usually what people ask, so I just put up here. So to start, so without further ado, let's get straight to the video. I hope you guys enjoy it. So firstly, let's start with some basic things like, you know, my name. So my name is Thiapong Sudhir. It's not Thaipong Sudhir. A lot of friends from North India calls me Thaipong Sudhir, which is not a correct pronunciation. It's T-I-A-P-O-N-G-T-Z-U-D-I-R. So where I am from? Where am I from? No? Where I am from? Where am I from? Anything. So I am from Dimapur, Nagaland. My parents live in Changi village, but then I grew up in Dimapur, Nagaland. So at Dimapur, which is like a town area, and my parents live in the village. But then though we also have like a place to stay in Dimapur, but my parents usually stay in village. So yeah, that's it. So what's your age and your date of birth? My age is 21. I'm 21 years of age. I am Capricorn and my birthday is on 14 January and I was born on 1999. What do you do in Delhi? So a lot of people ask me, what do you do in Delhi? Though I put up a lot of vlogs on universities and whatnot, but especially when it comes to new viewers and new subscribers, they usually tend to ask, what do I do in Delhi? So let me share with you guys. I'm doing my undergraduate in Ambedkar University, Delhi, and that's it. And the next question is, where do you live in Delhi? So I got this question when I first posted that home tour video, because a lot of people were telling me that the house that I have right now is a really good flat, and I think it's a really good flat as well. So a lot of people ask me which area is it. I cannot share exact location, but I stay in Lajpat Nagar, which is in South Delhi. So the next set of questions that I have put up are like some of the technical parts. So the first question is, which camera do you use? So right now I'm using a camera which I bought it from my money. Not just my money. So I used to have a camera when I first started my channel. It was Canon 200D, which was bought by my parents. So I sold off the camera, and then I got that money, and with that money I also added my money, and my parents' money, and then I joined them together and got the camera which I'm using now, which is a pretty good decent camera and very good camera for me actually. It's the Canon G7X Canon G7X Mark II. So it's small, handy, compatible, and very good for me. Yeah, a lot of YouTubers use as well. If you know YouTubers like Chitan Diary and Veronica Awungshi, and who else? A lot of people actually use this, even people abroad. I mean, even foreigners use it. So a lot of people do use this camera, and it's a good camera. And a lot of people saying, why don't you use microphone? Let me tell you one thing. The camera that I'm using right now does not have an microphone plug-in, so I'm not able to do it. If I ever upgrade my camera in like the next 2 to 3 years, I'll make sure that I buy a camera where I can put the microphone. Though I have a microphone, I'm not able to use it. That's a problem. So the next question that I have from a lot of people is, which editing software do you use? So I'm using the Filmora, Wondershare Filmora. I completely forgot which version is it. I'll make sure to put it up here. it's not the best of the best editing software, but then I got it because as you see in my videos are quite basic and I don't usually put up a lot of editing and you know all these things. It's just cut and copy. So Filmora does a good job for it. Filmora does a decent job for doing cut and copy, so that's the reason why I use Filmora. But if you're into more of those editing all those effects by giving transitions and whatnot, I think Adobe Premiere is a really good one, so I think you should consider using that. But if you're a new YouTuber and you just want it for cut and copy, I think Wondershare Filmora is a good decent one. You can also use the mobile version, which is a free app. And the next question is, who helps you shoot your videos? So usually it's me who is shooting, so whenever I shoot videos there is a little bit of pretending as well, since I have to put the camera there and pretend to be working from here and go here like this and all this. So I do it myself. I do the editing, I do the shooting, I write such things as well, questions, all these things. I do it all by myself. Yeah, that's it. So the next set of questions are quite personal, but I would also like to share because it's not so personal, but it's personal. But then now I'll make it private. Now I'll make it open. So the next question is, who are your roommates and whom do you live with? I get this in a lot of comments. So let me tell you, I live with my two cousin sisters, but then I just don't want to mention the word cousin sisters, so I usually use it as roommates to make it like short and simple. They're in the next room as well right now. That's it. Oh, and also a lot of people ask me if that girl who was in my previous video is my roommate. No, she's not from my roommate. She is my friend's sister, who is also my friend now. I mean, who is also my friend now. Yeah, she stays in Rajasthan, but she also got stranded here in Delhi because of the lockdown. So who cooks every day? This is also a question that I get a lot. So usually when it comes to cooking, my cousin sister does it, but then I also help sometimes. And usually when I shoot videos, I make sure that I cook, and that's it. And the next question is, do you earn from YouTube? So this question has been asked by a lot of people, especially on Instagram and whenever I just, you know, converse with someone. Yes, I do earn. I mean, earn as in, I don't earn in terms of 20,000, 30,000 or, you know, 10,000 or something like that, but I do earn like a decent amount of money, which, no, it's not even my pocket money. I get a decent amount of money, so, but I get it after 2-3 months or something like that, because my videos are not so good. I mean I don't get a lot of views and a lot of people subscribing to my channel as compared to others, so I don't really make good amount of money, but I do make a decent amount of money. I would also like to share that last month that I got money, I bought a Bible for myself. My mom has been asking me to buy a Bible on my own for a very long time, since I lost my Bible last time. I have one Bible at home, but I don't really like that Bible because it's a King James version, and I'm not really comfortable in reading King James version because I always grew up reading the new NIV Wala Bible. So I got myself a new Bible just today, and some few days back, and it reached today, which I bought it from my own earnings and savings. And also I did some things with my savings this month. I bought some things which I'm really proud of myself. This month I am happy that I did not ask my parents my pocket money. And I did ask, but then I was also, I didn't ask only, so, which is a good thing for myself. I was able to manage my own money and my parents doesn't know about it. So now whenever my mom and dad are watching this video, now they will know that I got some money, but it's already over because I bought some things. A lot of things actually. A lot of things as in not wants, like needs. Whenever there are comments like, you know, you are girlish or you're sissy or you act like a girl and all this, people ask me, do I mind? To be honest, no, I don't mind, because that's me and I cannot change the way I am on the internet just like that, because I want to be comfortable and be myself even out here. So I think I cannot change the way I am, and I think I'm fine being CC, or because I think I'm fine being CC and feminine and whatnot. And I think that's something unique in me, which a lot of people who comment saying don't act CC won't have that correct personality. And I think I'm proud, no, not I think, I'm proud of my personality and the uniqueness that I have of being feminine and whatnot. So I don't usually mind. But things like, you know, whenever someone called me Hijra, you are this, you are that, I think this is a very derogatory term, because whenever someone says you are Hijra and you are this and that, I think this marginalizes a lot of people from this community, like the Hijra community. It's not good to marginalize those group of people, because they are also humans just like us, and we cannot just marginalize some group of people because they are different or because we are different, because we all are different, and because of this diversity that we have that makes us humans. Whatever, I mean, you get it, no? So I think it's not good to marginalize a certain group of people like that. So please mind your words whenever you say things about Hijra and stuff, because they are also humans just like us, and we're also humans just like them. So that's all. Yeah, that's all. And you cannot expect every guy to behave the same way, or every girl to behave the same way. So please don't expect me to behave the same way like you expect me to behave. I'm just feminine and girly or whatever. So the next question is, how are you living your life during this lockdown here in Delhi, as Delhi is also the red zone? So let me tell you one thing. I'll just tell you like the personal views and everything. So for me, lockdown has been like one of those biggest changes in my life, especially in the last 10 years. As you guys know, that I'm someone who likes to go out every day and, you know, distract myself by going out, meeting friends, going out for having fun or whatnot, and trying to always run away from problems like staying, you know, sitting home and overthinking. Also, I want to say that, you know, if you guys are also having if you guys are also mentally disturbed by this lockdown, please make sure to feel free to, you know, voice it out. I mean, not voice out, share to your friends and whatnot, because I think you are not alone, because I'm also there because I also have this kind of things that I question a lot, and, you know, answer to myself, and I overthink a lot, and I also answer to myself, and which are usually negative traits. But then now things are better, so if you want to talk to me, you can always reach out to my Instagram and talk to me and feel free about it. So the last question that I have is, are you not going back home? Yes, I'm not going back home, and I'll tell you why. The fact that, you know, our Nagaland government does not have the best of the best facilities and cannot cater people for thousands and thousands that have registered. So I think it's not the best time to go home, and instead give chance to people who really needs to go home, because I feel like, you know, my parents can at least provide my needs up to this I think my parents can at least provide my needs right now. And also the government is giving out some assistance, so I'm taking those assistance and trying to survive with my parents' help and the assistance that I'm getting from the government. And also the second reason that I did not want to go home is because of the train and stuff. I mean, it's okay to go by train, but I feel like they are not taken care of properly, and the guidelines, the measure, the social physical distancing measures are not taken properly. So I was scared to also get infected and infect everyone back home. So that's the reason why I stayed back. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you guys like this video, please do consider to subscribe. And I think I have answered a lot of questions, and now you will get to know me better. So yeah, that's it, I hope. And if I have missed out some questions, you can ask me, so that next time I can also make sure to shoot one video like this where I answer you guys, who am I and what do I do. And yes, if you want to watch any type of video, you can comment down below and ask me what type of videos you want to watch, so that I can put up